Charles Stuart, King of England, you have been found guilty of high treason against the good people of this nation, represented in Parliament, by whose authority this court does sit in judgment upon you. And upon this charge, it is the sentence of this court that you be taken hence to an appointed place and put to death by the severing of the head from the body. And that is the sentence of the whole court.
Much has been said in this House about the so-called iniquity of certain members being financially involved in national projects. Members have ascribed to this state of affairs dark and sinister motives. I say if we in Parliament cannot gain from ruling the country, there's really very little point in our being here at all.
That this House be given power to remain in office a further 3 years without re-election.
Never!
Investigate the financial involvement of certain members.
It is 6 years since I handed over to you this great responsibility, in the hope that you would make good and wholesome laws which the people of this nation expected of you. I must confess to some abatement of my hopes. For what has happened in my absence? Instead of uniting the good people of this nation with righteousness and peace, which would have been a glorious and Christian thing to have done, what do I find? Anarchy, corruption, division, and dissatisfaction. I say that the enemies of this nation have flourished under your protection. You were from the beginning a provisional government not truly representative of the people, but have the people elected you? Has this House gone once to the people it purports to represent? No, it has not. And now, after 6 years of misgovernment, what do we find? Sir Thomas Fairfax moves a bill to give this House a further lease of this worthless and dishonorable life. Gentlemen, an immovable Parliament is more obnoxious than an immovable king. They're drunkards, tricksters, villains, whoremasters, godless, self-seeking, ambitious tricksters. You are no more capable of conducting the affairs of this nation than you are of running a brothel.
You are impotent, sir.
You are scum, sir. And a truly elected scum of that. This is no Parliament. I shall put an end to your sitting. I hereby declare this Parliament dissolved.
Yes, sir. Colonel Harrison.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Remove them.
Come on, get them out.
I will liberate man's soul from the darkness of ignorance. I will build schools and universities for all. This will become the golden age of learning. I will bring the law within the reach of every common man. There'll be work and bread for all. This nation